Hello, dear fans, friends, and subscribers. This is your host Ram, welcoming you to your regular edition of the Cricket Happening Show today. And on this particular Cricket Happening Show, there's a lot of cricket going on right now. When I'm talking to you, I will take you down live to the ground where the second One Day International of the Chapel Hadley Trophy series is being played. And in fact, the match has not started, but this is the second One Day International today, which is going to be played between New Zealand and Australia at Wellington. And the news from the centre here is that New Zealand have actually won the toss and they have decided to actually bat first in this particular pitch. New Zealand are definitely going with a unchanged side there, but as far as Australia are concerned, they have made three changes. They have actually got in Usman Khawaja into the mix now, and so it's going to be pretty interesting. Usman Khawaja has taken Sean Marsh's place. Scott Boland has been brought in after Kane Richardson was a bit costly, so Scott Boland gets his opportunity in New Zealand for the first time. And also Adam Zampa, the leg spinner, is actually making his debut in One Day Internationals. And today he was given the as a sort of a tradition that Australia has, the baggy green cap was handed over to Adam Zampa, the right-arm leg spinner, by Alan Border, the former great batsman from Australia. Well, one thing that one can say here is that definitely there is a blow for New Zealand or for Australia, no doubt about it, as the news has just peeped in that Adam Zampa, the leg spinner, has got his opportunity because James Faulkner, the all-rounder, is out of the New Zealand tour. And it's pretty sad because we know what value James Faulkner adds to the Australian team. Well, so I'll keep you posted. I'll keep you as and when the match starts, I'll tell you. So right now, the news from the centre is that New Zealand have won the toss here on the second ODI here between New Zealand and Australia at the Basin Reserve in Wellington. And New Zealand have elected to bat first. So the next thing that I would be covering on this particular cricket show is the host India actually announced their team for both the Asia Cup and the T20 World Cup. And the great thing for India is that the best bowler in World Cup 2015 was Mohammad Shami in Australia, as you would remember. And after that, he was injured and he was not fit. And it's almost a long time. He missed a lot of matches played by India because of injury, and finally I'm told he has regained his physical fitness and he's up and running and he has been selected. So that's the big change in the Indian team. So Mohammad Shami is definitely going to strengthen the Indian team, and that is what everyone wanted, because Mohammad Shami is a very important cog in the Indian scheme of things, and he has been selected. So he's there both in the Asia Cup and T20 World Cup. So that is something that I'm going to definitely talk about. I will have a glance at the team and do a brief preview and give my analysis of the team. And also tomorrow, South Africa take on England in the second One Day International. The first One Day International, which was decided with the Lewis method, but the second One Day International tomorrow is going to be played at Port Elizabeth. And South Africa, England, and definitely the onus will be on South Africa to see whether they can square the series tomorrow. Well, so, and also some cricket news. The cricket news that is coming in, especially the Under-19 World Cup, is very refreshing for the host Bangladesh, as host Bangladesh have made it to the semi-finals of the Under-19 World Cup by becoming the first team in the Under-19 World Cup to actually go on and actually make it to the semi-finals of the Under-19 World Cup. So Bangladesh, the hosts, have done a great thing here. Their Under-19 World Cup team is into the semi-finals, as today they beat Nepal. And the other news that I have, this is coming in from the Pakistan Super League, where there was a match which was played between, I think it was Lahore and Karachi, I reckon. And Mohammad Amir plays for the Karachi team. And Mohammad Amir today took a hat-trick. He dismissed three batsmen in the 19th over to sink the Lahore team to a very low score of 125/8, and then it was the Karachi team that notched that up at 131/3. They got a 7-wicket victory, but the feature was that Mohammad Amir got a hat-trick in this particular match. He, in fact, clean bowled Dwayne Bravo middle stump. The next delivery, he dismissed Zohaib Khan, and then Kevon Cooper was sent back to the pavilion. In the 19th over, he took the hat-trick. So that is something. So depending on time, I will dwell on all those things. But definitely, I would also keep an eye on the second ODI, as I said, between New Zealand and Australia, as I think there are another 3 minutes for this ODI, One Day International, that is the second One Day International, to have a start at the Basin Reserve in Wellington. So I'm just going to see as to what's the situation right now, which's happening at the Basin Reserve in Wellington. We are still away from that. I mean, it has still not started. We are still winter, as you know. This is known as a cake tin, as you know, the Basin Reserve in Wellington. Well, so let me start off with the Indian team that has been selected. As you know, the Indian T20 squad, India are the hosts of the World Cup, the T20 World Cup, which is going to be played in the month of March 8th. It starts on March the 8th, and the India T20 squad has been selected not only for the World T20, but also for the Asia Cup. Let's have a look at the teams here. As I said, the important inclusion and the best inclusion that one could talk about is Mohammad Shami being included. Mohammad Shami, who was, as I've already mentioned, that Mohammad Shami was not there in the team, and he was, as I said, he was the best bowler in the 2015 World Cup, and I think this is going to definitely strengthen the Indian team, as the Indian bowling, the pace bowling department will be manned by Mohammad Shami, who would definitely be the strike bowler for India. Ashish Nehra is there in the team, and Jasprit Bumrah, who did very impressively against Australia in Australia, is definitely there. So he's there. So definitely, this team is looking like sort of having a balance. They have a left-arm seamer, left-arm pace bowler, Ashish Nehra, and then you have Jasprit Bumrah and Mohammad Shami, who would be manning the pace department. And then looking at the team, the other people all, and Virat Kohli, who was left out for the Sri Lankan tour, for the match against Sri Lanka, has come back. So Virat Kohli is back into the T20 squad for the World T20 and the Asia Cup. What India has done is India have selected the same team for both the Asia Cup and the World T20. Dhoni is the captain. Rohit Sharma, Shikhar Dhawan, we know what a very established opening one-day pair they are now, as far as Indian cricket is concerned. Virat Kohli, then we have those very, very versatile Ajinkya Rahane, Suresh Raina, Yuvraj Singh, who didn't really get a chance in Australia, will get his chance in India. Hardik Pandya, of whom one has not seen, one definitely saw his bowling in Australia, but one definitely has not seen his batting, definitely, so which one was waiting for, because he definitely has all those, I would say, definitely has all the potential to become a very big hitter of the ball, no doubt about it. He has the potential, he's a potential big hitter, and I'm sure the Indian crowd would be waiting to see Hardik Pandya in action. This Hardik Pandya, from the body language that we saw as to how he was in Australia, I feel his body language is absolutely aggressive, and that's the way to go. Then, as far as spin department is concerned, that was expected. Ravindra Jadeja and Arshwin selecting themselves. Harbhajan Singh is there. Harbhajan Singh, as you remember, did not get any did not play any match in Australia, but definitely, I'm sure he's going to get his chance here. And then this is something which I already talked about. Pawan Negi has also held his place, both in the. In fact, he was, as you know, Pawan Negi is a left-arm spinning all-rounder. He was selected for the matches that, like Sri Lanka, who are coming and going to play 3 T20s against India. He was selected for that, but I'm in fact, Pawan Negi, the India has already gone forward by putting Pawan Negi in the team. So I'm sure Pawan Negi will be very happy that he has also booked the ticket for both the Asia Cup and the T20 World Cup. Just talking about Pawan Negi, he's a left-arm spinning all-rounder. He's a good left-arm spinner. He's done well. He's a very quick left-arm spinner. And the good thing is that he's a very good lower-order hitter of the ball. So I think this T20 squad is looking like... let's see who are the players who were to miss out If you look at the players, Mishra, Bhuvneshwar Kumar, one knows that he did very well against England. He batted well. But, you know, his main, what one is looking at Bhuvneshwar Kumar is his bowling. And one feels that Bhuvneshwar Kumar has lost his sting here. And I think he has to probably go back to the drawing board. He has to make some adjustments and come back in the Indian team. But so Bhuvneshwar Kumar, because of his poor form, has been left out. But yes, definitely one feels sorry for Manish Pandey, who actually got his maiden one day international century in the only Indian win in the ODIs in Australia. And yes, I understand that Manish Pandey is a very, very talented bloke. But let me tell you, if you look at this Indian team and you have to look at the balance, I feel sorry that one understands that Manish Pandey is a good player, but I would say my commiserations to Manish Pandey, because he's a very, very talented bat, no doubt about it. He has already shown it. I mean, to come and make a century in a one-day international against Australia, in Australia, in Australian conditions, and that too coming at a crisis time, doing it takes some real doing. So Manish Pandey, definitely there is a real talent in this boy, Manish Pandey. Definitely his time is going to come, but at least for the time being, he will be missing the Asia Cup and the World and the T20 World Cup. But Manish Pandey, wish you good luck. I'm sure one knows that he will definitely come back to the team one in the future for sure. So Manish Pandey, I had to miss out because it's all about the composition of the team. And if you look at the composition and if you look at all the players, all those players have been performing, and I think the India team is looking pretty sharp here. And as you know, the experts have been already a lot of experts, cricketing experts, have been telling that India are favourites for the T20 World Cup. Well, one has to wait and watch. Maybe one has to really give it some time before making a statement, but definitely the cricketing experts have already voiced saying that India definitely looking like everybody are many, like one saw that Sachin Tendulkar from India and Brian Lara from the West Indies, they both had mentioned that India are looking favourites for the T20 World Cup. Yes, they definitely are contenders, no doubt about it. They are the hosts of the team, they have the home advantage, and one should have a great series, no doubt about it. Well, dear fans and subscribers, as far as if you look at the team, yes, one man who missed out here, Akshar Patel, who has been given a lot of chances, has finally not really lived up to the expectations. He has been taken off. And Amit Mishra also, as you know, Amit Mishra has also been left out. So Amit Mishra has till now, he has never played a T20 for India, but he has been left out. So that is the as far as the Indian team is concerned. So I think this Indian team is looking really balanced, and I think that there is nothing that we can say. In the meanwhile, I'll just give you a live cricket update here. As I see, the first over has been bowled by Josh Hazlewood, as the New Zealand openers have just got two runs right now. Brendan McCullum and Nadeem Gupta on one piece. So the match is underway here. As I'm talking to you, it's Brendan McCullum. After the quiet over that took place from Josh Hazlewood, here comes Brendan McCullum and picks up a boundary of the very first ball that was bowled by John Hastings. I'll be telling you as to how we hit it. I'll come back to that later. In the meanwhile, let's have a short preview of the South Africa versus England match, which is coming up. As far as the South Africa, while I'm talking to you, I think there is, I'm just trying to see whether there is any, well, the score has moved on to 8 right now. So definitely with that boundary that Brendan McCullum hit, it has moved on for. In fact, Brendan McCullum has also hit the second delivery from John Hastings for another boundary. So definitely McCullum has started his fireworks right here. I'll come back to that later. And as far as the South Africa England is concerned, tomorrow is the second one day international, which is going to be played at the Port Elizabeth. South Africans, definitely, I thought that match was definitely hanging in balance. South Africa could have also done it with Quinton de Kock looking pretty energetic at the crease there. But the Duckworth-Lewis method came into equation. So as far as South Africa are concerned, South Africa are looking good. Ashi Mamla, who was dismissively, but Quinton de Kock is something good to happen for them. That Quinton de Kock, after a long, long time, and saw that Quinton de Kock got into some good form in the One Day Internationals. And that is something which is always expected, because with Quinton de Kock getting into form, it also makes it easy for the South African team. So for the South African team to do it, actually. If you look at the team there, what it does is, you know, AB de Villiers is the captain. So Quinton de Kock keeping the wickets and opening the innings definitely allows for an extra batsman to be coming into the team. Duplessis is looking in good nick after quite a long time. AB de Villiers will be captaining the side. He has been into a bit of a sort of a lull here, but I'm sure he's going to get through it. Then they have JP Duni. They have Lily Rozu, who is a very talented bat. Farhan Baradin is there to give them some solidity to proceedings there. Chris Morris is a very nice bowler. Kagiso Rabada is back. We know that in the previous match, one did not see Kagiso Rabada, but now Kagiso Rabada is back. And then we have Kyle Abbott, and then whether Imran Tahir will play, that's the question, or whether it's going to be Morning Motor. That would be interesting to see as to what really happens. As far as England are concerned, I think this England team is absolutely talented, no doubt about it. They have lots of energy in their squad, absolutely. And Jason Roy, as I said, is looking a pure talent. He looks a pristine talent for me, Jason Roy. Because when I had a glimpse at him, the way he strokes the ball, he makes batting look pretty easy. He hits some effortless strokes. He rolls his wrist nicely when playing the strokes. And that's all mark of a pretty good player. So Jason Roy and Alex Hales are already good, looking in good nick. And they have the solidity of Joe Root, Morgan the big hitter, Ben Stokes the puncher. And then they have Josh Butler, the dasher. And then Moeen Ali is another one who will also add some sort of oomph to this batting lineup. And the bowling will be in the hands of the specialists, I would say, in T20 now. Sorry, in One Day Internationals, David Willey. And Reece Topley would be opening the bowling attack, supported by whether they would like to go for Stuart Broad, that remains to be seen, or whether they would be sticking with Chris Jordan. Chris Jordan was a bit costly the other day, and Adil Rashid couldn't make much of an impression the other day. But Adil Rashid is coming on some good form in this Big Bash League, as you would all know. Now, as far as the forecast is concerned, in Port Elizabeth, I'm told it's a very, very sunny day. So definitely, one knows if it's going to be sunny, and I'm sure the batsmen are going to make hay while the sun is going to shine there brightly at Port Elizabeth. So the next, and while I'm talking to you, let's have a look at the score here. Well, this particular over, in fact, has been a good over for New Zealand. 2 fours into the first two balls, and then finally some sanity to proceedings as the end of over two takes 11 runs. And right now, as I'm talking to you, New Zealand in the third over, which has just begun, are 15 for no loss after winning the toss and electing to bat first. Now, just a tidbit news before I leave this cricket happening show for the day today. First, let me say that the host Bangladesh have entered the semi-finals of the Under-19 World Cup by getting a win over Nepal. So that is something good for them, being the host of the team. It is something that they had to do, and they have done it. So it's I think one has to really commend Bangladesh for making it to the semi-finals Under-19 World Cup. World Cup here. And let's see the Pakistan Super League. As I said, the Pakistan Super League, the match, the feature was all about Mohammad Amir, the left-arm pace bowler, going on and taking a hat-trick. When he dismissed Dwayne Bravo, middle stump out of the ground, then he had Zohaib Khan, and in the very next ball, he dismissed Kevon Cooper. 3 balls, 3 wickets at the 19th over to sink the Lahore to 125 for 8, and then Karachi wiping it off in pretty well by getting a 7-wicket victory. Well, dear fans, friends, subscribers, always a pleasure bringing you this cricket happening show and sharing my thoughts with you on all the cricket matches played, and of any previews, analysis, or whatever the case may be. Hope you all like this cricket show of mine. It's almost time for me to bid goodbye on this cricket show here on a Friday. But on Saturday, your host Ram would be back while I'm talking to you. McCallum has just hit a 6-year. This is the third over which has been bowled. In fact, it was McCallum just charging down the track, and he just converted a good length ball into a full length delivery and launched the ball over the extra cover boundary for a six. What a shot! Magnificent shot from Brendan McCallum. Well, what a sad scene that one is not going to see Brendan McCallum in action after the month of February. What a thorough entertainer he has been, not only for New Zealand cricket or New Zealand public, but for the world fans of cricket all the world over. Well, it's a pretty sad sight, but yes, Brendan McCallum won't be seen after this series against Australia, unfortunately. Definitely, as he's there, and I think there is one. As I'm talking to you, there is one more six which is hit by Brendan McCallum. What a shot from Brendan McCallum! This man is someone who can really, really murder the Australian attack. Oh my word, what a shot from Brendan McCallum. Went onto the front foot and he hooked the bouncer, and it was absolutely lightning stuff as the ball sailed into the stands for a beautiful six from Brendan McCallum's bat. Well, dear fans, subscribers, so New Zealand are slowly upping the ante here as the score moves to 27 for no loss in 3 overs. So, well, dear fans, friends, subscribers, I will be there back with you tomorrow on Saturday to talk about this match between New Zealand and Australia. And also, I'd be talking about the South Africa versus England match. And if at all any other cricket news is there, I'm always there to share it with you, dear fans and subscribers of Cricket Happenings. That only leaves me here to say to all my dear